नमस्ते बच्चों, हमेशा खुश रहो बच्चों। मैं सेल्फ ओम प्रकाश, फैकल्टी ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स अंडर फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मैथोलॉजी। टुडे आई टॉट यू कॉम्प्लेक्स एनालिसिस एंड द नेम ऑफ द मॉड्यूल इज कन्फॉर्मल मैपिंग विच आर टॉट इन बीएससी बीएड पीजीएम 8 सेमेस्टर स्टूडेंट। दीज आर द लेसन प्लानिंग, दीज आर द स्टेप फॉर प्लानिंग ए लेसन, these are the components of a lesson plan. In complex analysis, in your last class I will see some transformation on conformal transformation such as translation, rotation, magnification. Today I see the combined effect of rotation as well as magnification. In rotation as well as magnification, we see that the transformation will be taken as omega equals to alpha z into beta complex. We can write here omega equals to rho e to the power I phi, beta equals to b e to the power I delta, and z equals to r e to the power I theta. Then the transformation can be written as rho e to the power I phi equals to b e to the power I delta dot r e to the power I theta is equals to br e to the power I theta plus delta. Therefore, rho equals to br and phi equals to theta plus delta. Here, rho equals to br represents the magnification and phi equals to theta plus delta represents the rotation of the curve. Thus, the given transform maps the point P r theta, as shown in the figure. In the z plane, into the point Q in the omega plane, whose polar coordinates are r P r theta delta, theta plus delta. In other words, to obtain the image Q of the point P in the z plane, we rotate the radius vector OP, radius vector OP about the origin through an angle delta equals to arc beta, and then magnify OP in the ratio beta is just 1. Hence, the point Q, which represents omega, is such that angle, you can see from the figure, angle QOP is equals to angle BOX, which is nothing but arc beta. Similarly OQ equals to OB into OP, OB into OP. Now the rotation is taken as anti-clockwise or clockwise according to beta greater than 0 or beta less than 0. That means arc beta greater than 0. If arc beta greater than 0, then we will take anti-clockwise direction, or when arc beta less than 0, then we will take clockwise direction. And the magnification is expansion or construction, expansion or construction according as mod beta greater than 0 or mod beta less than, sorry, mod beta greater than 1 or mod beta less than 1. And also there is no magnification if mod beta is equal to 1, and no rotation if arc beta equals to 0. The above figure is drawn for beta, arc beta greater than 0 and mod beta greater than 0, which can be exemplified with the help of this example. Let us consider the rectangular region D in Z plane be bounded by the line x equals to 0, that means y axis, y equals to 0, that means x axis, x equals to 2, that means parallel to y axis at a distance x equals to 2, y equals to 3 means parallel to x axis at a distance y equals to 3. Then we have to determine omega, sorry, d dash of the omega plane into which D is mapped under the transformation omega equals to root 2 e to the power I pi by 4 into z. Root 2 e to the power I pi by 4 into z. Now, we know that omega equals to u plus iv and z equals to x plus iy. Therefore, u plus iv equals to under root 2 e to the power I pi by 4 x plus iy. On multiplying and breaking e to the power I pi by 4 into trigonometric function, we got root 2 cos pi by 4 plus I sine pi by 4. And we already know that cos pi by 4 is equal to 1 and sine pi by 4 equals to 1. Therefore, u plus iv becomes 1 plus I 1 by root 2 and sine pi by 4 is equal to 1 by root 2. Root 2 will be cancelled out from this root 2. Therefore, our u plus iv will become 1 plus I equals to into x plus iy. This is nothing but simple multiplication of two complex numbers. The resultant of this complex number is multiplication of this complex number is x minus y plus I x plus y. Hence, here we got u equals to x minus y and v equals to x plus y. Thus, from the given figure, we will take x equals to 0. X equals to 0 is mapped into the u equals to. When we put x equal to 0, we will get u equals to minus y. U equals to minus y, that means these line. And here, x equal to 0, u equals to y. That means u equals to minus v. Or v equals to minus u. These line, that means u plus v equals to 0. This line. That means y equals to 0 becomes u plus v equals to 0. Again, the line y equals to 0, we will take y equals to 0, then u equals to x, and y equals to 0, then v equals to x. That means u equals to v, or u minus v equals to, or v minus u equals to 0. That means this line. That means x equals to 0, line become u plus v equals to 0, and y equals to 0 line become u equals to v. Again, we will take x equal to 2, then x equal to 2 minus y, u becomes 2 minus y, and v becomes 2 plus y. Therefore, the relation between u and v for x equal to 2 is u equals to u plus v equals to 4. And finally, for the line y equals to 3 is mapped with u minus v equals to 6. All the graph are represented with the help of these lines, and the common region is known as D dash. Therefore, our region D will transform into the region D dash with some magnification as well as rotation. And the rotation between these graph will be taken as this angle. That means this angle is 45 degree in anti-clockwise direction. And the stretching is nothing but root 2. Now, I'm going to take a new transformation, which are known as inversion. The inversion is taken as the omega equals to 1 by z. If simply z plane, we will take omega equals to rho e to the power I phi and z equals to r e to the power I theta. Then we get rho e to the power I phi equals to 1 by r e to the power I theta equals to 1 by r e to the power minus I theta. Therefore, rho equals to 1 by r and omega equals to mod omega equals to mod 1 by z, and therefore phi equals to minus theta. That is argument of omega equals to minus argument of z. This Gibbs transformation may be considered as the resultant of the two transformation, like z equals to 1 by z equals to 1 by z e to the power I theta and omega equals to z bar. Omega equals to z bar. No, the first is the inversion with regard to the unit circle mod r equals to 1. This means that the point z lies on the radius drawn through the point z, and its distance from the center is such that mod z small z into mod capital z equals to 1. This inversion is followed by the reflection omega equal to capital Z bar in the real axis. Omega equal to capital Z bar in the real axis. Thus, the point inside the unit circle are mapped into point outside the circle and vice versa. The point of the circle are reflected in the real axis, which are shown in the figure. Let us consider one more example on inversion. The example is find the image of the infinite strips. Find the image of the infinite strips 1 by 4 less than y less than 1 by 2. Or second one is the 0 less than y less than 1 by 2. Under the transformation omega equals to 1 by z, and saw the reason graphically. Now, we already know omega equals to u plus iv and z equals to x plus iy. Then we have u plus iv equals to 1 by z plus iy. Sorry, x plus iy. After rationalizing this, we got x minus iy by x square plus y square. Therefore, on comparing both sides with real and imaginary parts, we got u equals to x by x square plus y square and v equals to minus y by x square plus y square. Thus, we can see that u by v equals to minus x by y, or x equals to minus u y by v, or so that v equals to y by u square x square, sorry, u square y square by v square plus y square. After simplification, we got v equals to y. We got minus v square by u square plus v square into y. Therefore, we can say y equals to v by u square plus y square. And x, already we find x equals to minus u y by v. Now, so taking the second one, first one, the first one is y varies from 1 by 4 to 1 by 2. Therefore, if y equals to 1 by 4, then minus b by u square plus v square equals to 1 by 4. Therefore, u square plus v square plus 4, v equals to 0. Or we can say u square plus v plus 2 whole square equals to 4. Thus, if y equals to 1 by 2, then minus u by v by u square plus v square equals to 1 by 2. Or therefore, after simplifying, we got u square plus v plus 1 whole square equals to 1. Both of them are a circle with center. The first one is a circle with center 0, minus 2, and second one is a circle with center 0, minus 1. Here, the infinite strip minus 1 by 4 to 1 by 4 is transformed into the region common to the circle u square plus v plus 1 whole square equals to 1, and second one is the u square plus v plus 2 whole square equals to 4 in the omega plane, as shown in the following figure by strip. Therefore, our graph will represent as y equals to 1 by 4 or y equals to 1 by 2 will become a small circle and capital circle respectively. These are the in omega z plane, these are in omega plane. Now, the second part is left for the exercise. When y equals to 0 and v equals to 0, and also y greater than 0, v less than 0, therefore we know that v equals to minus y by x square plus y square. That means in this case, as we proceed, as proceeded in the previous example. This is left for your exercise.